फ्रेंड्स टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट वर्क डन एंड पार ऑलरेडी वी हैव लर्न दैट वर्क डन इज गिवन बाय द फॉर्मूला W is equal to F into S. Also, we have defined work done, or work is said to be done if a force acting on the body causes displacement in it. So in our lower classes we have learned that work is said to be done if a force acting on the body causes a displacement in it. So if you consider a body, you apply force, then the body must displace. This is the displacement caused. So in such cases work is said to be done. Now, this formula W is equal to F into S is a very general formula. Here, if you just observe the direction of force and the direction of displacement are same. Means in whichever direction you are applying the force, in the same direction there is displacement caused. But in our everyday life, we come across many situations where force and displacement will not be in the same directions. In such cases, this formula should be extended to something else. It is not merely W is equal to F into S. Because what happens? In many cases we come across force and displacement will not be in the same direction. They will be acting in different directions. In such cases, you have to modify this formula W is equal to F into S. Now, if you observe here, force and displacement, both are vector quantities. Both are vectors. They are vector quantities. Now, what is a vector? Vector is a physical quantity which has both magnitude and direction. Now, whenever I say I am applying some force, I will be stating the direction in which the force is applied. Along with that, how much force is applied, what amount of force is applied also will be mentioned. Now, magnitude means it is just a numerical value. Suppose if I say force F is equal to 10 newtons, then here 10 is the magnitude. Along with it, we also indicate the direction. So, force is equal to 10 newtons towards east. If I write, it means that the force of magnitude 10 newtons is applied towards east. So, force becomes a vector quantity. At the same time, even displacement also takes place in a particular direction, and displacement also has some magnitude. So, both force and displacement are vectors. Now, according to vectors resolution, means if you resolve these two vectors, force and displacement, then we can come to a more precise formula for work done. Now, two cases we have to remember here. Work done where we are taking the component of displacement along force. So, if you take the component of displacement along force, then the work done formula will be equal to F into S cos theta. This is by resolution of vectors. F into S cos theta. At the same time, if you take the component of force along displacement, then the formula would be W is equal to F cos theta into S. Now, these two formula, how we will arrive, it is based on the resolution of force and displacement. Of course, resolution of vectors is not in detail according to the scope of the syllabus, But we need to know about these two formula, because here you will come to know, sometimes as I told you, force and displacement will not be acting in the same direction. They might be acting at an angle. For example, force might be acting in this direction, displacement will be in this direction. Or force is acting towards this direction, displacement also in the same direction. In some cases, we come across force is acting in this direction, displacement in the opposite direction. In such cases, we have to take the angle between the two vectors. That's why these two vectors should be resolved. And according to resolution of vectors, we will get two more formulae. That is, W is equal to F into S cos theta if we take the component of displacement along force. And W is equal to F cos theta into S if you take the component of force along displacement. So, apart from this formula, W is equal to F into S, you should also remember W is equal to Fs cos theta. So, these two formula you have to remember. Sometimes in numerical problems, we will be given the angle between the force and displacement. In such cases, you have to find the cos of that angle and go ahead with the numerical problem. Now, so as I told you, both force and displacement are vectors. And work done is a scalar. Work done is a scalar. Whereas force and displacement are vectors. So work done is given by the dot product of two vectors. Like this it has to be written. Work done is a scalar quantity and it is written as the dot product of two vectors. So, this is the formula you have to remember. This is called dot product or vector product. Now, so we have to remember the formula for work done as W is equal to F into S. And one more formula, W is equal to Fs cos theta. Now we shall learn some special cases where we come across force and displacement acting in different directions. So, simple definition, as I have told you, if you apply force in this direction, displacement also will be in the same direction. In such cases, we are using the formula F into S. Now we have to go little further, one step further, where force and displacement will be acting in the same directions. So, depending on the direction of force and displacement, we get some three cases in work done. So, sometimes work done can be positive, sometimes work done can be negative, and in some cases, work done will be zero. Now, let us take one example where work done will be positive, zero, and negative. The first one, work done. Positive. So, when work done will be positive. Now, consider a body. It is dropped down. So, a body is dropped from a certain height, H. From this height, the body is dropped down. Now, here you just see in which direction the force will be acting. Now, whenever any body is dropped down to earth, then always remember there will be force of gravity acting. Force of gravity acting, and this force of gravity will be always directed towards the center of the earth. So, here the force on the body is acting towards the earth and its magnitude is given by F is equal to mg. Now, when you drop this body, in which direction the body travels? The body travels in the direction of force only. So, this is the direction of displacement. Now, vertical displacement, always we will take it as height. So, here you observe that the force due to gravity is acting towards the ground, towards the center of the earth always, and displacement is also acting towards the earth. So what we come across here, force and displacement are along the same direction in such cases. So W will be equal to F into S. This will be the formula. So W is equal to Fs. So here also work is done due to force of gravity, means the gravity is pulling the body towards itself. So the work done due to the force of gravity will be equal to mgh. Now how we get mgh? F is equal to mg, that is force due to gravity. And as I told you, the vertical displacement, we can just write it as height also. So W is equal to F into S, W is equal to mgh. In such cases, work done is positive. So whenever work done is positive, what is the formula we will use? W is equal to F into S. This is case 1 for work done, where work done is positive. Now, let us take case 2, where work done can be 0. Now, consider a man. He is carrying a load on his shoulder. So this is the load, and the man is moving in this direction. So this person is carrying a load on his shoulder and he is moving in this direction. Now let us see in which direction the force will be acting and in which direction the displacement is. The displacement, as we know, the displacement is in this direction, whereas the force of gravity, it will be always acting towards the earth. So here you can observe that the force is acting in this direction and displacement is acting at right angle to the direction of force. Or we can tell that the displacement is normal to force. In such cases, which formula you have to use? You have to use the formula W is equal to Fs cos theta. Now, you just substitute this angle. What is the angle between force and displacement? It is 90 degrees. So, Fs cos 90. And we know that cos 90 is 0. So, W will be equal to 0. So, this is an example where we find the work done can be 0. So always remember, when work done can be 0, work done is said to be 0 if force and displacement are acting at right angles. Sometimes what happens, even if displacement is 0, then also work done will be 0. Suppose if you try to push a wall, then you are applying force on the wall. See, this is the wall and the man is trying to is applying force on the wall. He is applying force, of course, but the wall does not move. There is no displacement. Displacement is equal to 0. In such cases, again we will get W is equal to 0, because if you see here in this formula, when displacement becomes 0, F is equal to 0. Or if you take here also, S is 0, so work done also will be 0. So remember, work done can be 0 in two cases. So W is equal to 0 if S is equal to 0 and F and S are at right angle to each other. So this is the second case where work done can be 0. Now let us take the third case. Sometimes work done can be negative also. Now let us take, a ball is projected upwards. This is ground level. Whenever you project a ball upwards, then what happens? The ball will reach a certain height and then it comes back to the ground again. But when you project the ball upwards, what happens? Displacement is taking place in the upward direction. but force due to gravity will be acting towards the center of the earth. So this will be the direction of force, this will be the direction of displacement. If you observe here, force and displacement are in opposite directions. So in such cases, again use the formula F is equal to, W is equal to Fs cos theta. This is equal to Fs cos, what is the angle between these two? The angle will be 180. And we know that cos 180 is minus 1. Therefore, W is equal to minus F into S. So these are the three cases we have to remember where work done can be positive, work done can be zero, and work done can be negative. Now we shall know what are the units of work. So if you take the formula W is equal to F into S, the force is measured in Newton according to Standard International, and displacement is measured in meters. So the units for work done will be Newton meter. But we know that work is nothing but energy. So you can use joule also as the units of work done. So any type of work done, it can be measured in terms of joules, because work done is nothing but energy. Now let us take about power. We have learned about power also in our lower classes, and we have defined power as the rate at which work is done. The rate at which work is done. Now when I say about power, it can be mechanical power, it can be electrical power also. So here we are considering just power. Now when I say work, work done can be due to any type of energy. It can be electrical energy or it can be due to mechanical energy also. So in general, we define power as rate at which work is done. So what is the formula we have learnt? P is equal to W by T. This is the formula you have to remember. Now, as I told you, work is nothing but energy. In such cases, you can even write P is equal to E by T also. Here, E is the electrical energy. In such cases, electrical energy consumed in a definite time is nothing but power. But we shall concentrate on this formula, P is equal to W by T. This is the general formula for power. Now, units of power also we know. Work done is measured in joule. Time is measured in second. So, joule per second, also called watt, is the unit of power. Now, apart from this formula, one more formula we have to remember. See, P is equal to W by T. Now, what is W? W is nothing but work done. Now, already we have learnt about work done. Work done is how much? Work done, W is equal to F into S. Now, instead of writing W, I substitute here P is equal to F into S by T. Now just observe in this formula, F into S by T. This S by T, if you take, S is nothing but displacement and T is nothing but time. And we know that displacement by time is equal to velocity. Velocity is rate of change of displacement. So here also we have rate of change of displacement. In such cases, I can write P is equal to F into V. This is one more very, very important formula you have to remember. P is equal to F into V.